What's going on, guys?
Action.
What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about applying CU. Yes, I like to abbreviate this CU. I'm putting it right there in the bottom what CU stands for with OSDCloud. So let's get right into it. All right. So, yes, I'm going to be saying CU a lot because it's abbreviated, it's short, it's simple. I'm going to constantly put it at the bottom what CU means. So, don't freak out. First thing that we need to do is download the KB update that we want to integrate into our OSDCloud image. So open up your favorite browser. I open up Microsoft Edge. Does not mean it is my favorite one. I'm just doing it on this particular machine. We're going to go into this particular site, type it in. And once you type it in, we're going to hit enter. It's going to load this up. Awesome. If you have the KB number, enter the KB number. For this example, we are going to do KB5039302. Once you enter your KB number in that text box, click on search or just hit enter and it should locate it. Now, this is the CU. This is a preview for Windows 11, 23 or 22 H2. So pick the one that you want, pick your flavor. The size are pretty big. It's between 700 to 800 megabytes. So this is a pretty big CU. The one that I picked, if I remember, was Windows 11 22 H2. So I clicked on the download button. If this pops up, awesome. I'm going to basically click on that MSU link. Click on it and it should start automatically downloading for you. Now, this is pretty big. It is around 726 megabytes. Once it's completed, you're going to get this. Awesome. I'm going to click on that little folder, right? Click on that folder and it's going to redirect me to the downloads folder. So click on it. Boom. There goes the MSU file. Awesome. Now, what I did with this particular file is I moved it somewhere else. I created a folder underneath my D partition and I called it OSDCloud updates and I dropped that CU in there. Excellent. Before I do anything, I held the shift key. I right click on that update and I selected copy as path because we are going to be needing that path pretty soon. So open up PowerShell. I open up PowerShell ISE as a full administrator. And the first command that I like to do is the following. We're going to do a git OSDCloud template. This is actually going to show me what is my default template, which is BTNHD production. Now, I kind of messed up because when I did the following command, which I'm going to show you guys, it actually installed the CU update within my default OSDCloud template. Yeah, I know. But this is how you infuse or integrate a Windows update within your OSDCloud. We're going to run the following command, new OSDCloud template. Right there off the bat, it tells you new. It's going to create a new OSDCloud template. We're going to use this particular parameter and the path that we copied. We're going to paste it here. Awesome. And we're going to hit enter. This is going to take some time, but if you take a look at the output, this process for me took around 38 minutes and 23 seconds. And the OSD template was created at OSDCloud. I typically like to run the following git OSDCloud template. This right here told me that it went to the default OSDCloud template. If you want to revert back to your production or your development one, you're able to run set OSDCloud template with a parameter of name and the name of your, cloud template. This is the one that I want it to default into. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.